The Redmi Note 7 Pro was a super hyped phone. I mean, just look at the sales. And it's still in flash sale available for the exact same price as launch, 5 months into the launch. So clearly it has a tough demand. And I would like to know what the bugs have been addressed, as it came with quite a few of them, and the improvements that MIUI has made since the launch, and updates plus the bugs it has fixed. Before I start explaining, please get subscribed to my channel for daily tech content. Well, not daily, but frequently, I would say. And also like this video and encourage my work. I would be pretty hyped if I can get somewhere around 30, 40, 50 likes. I would love it. Also, share it to your friends and family if they were looking for something in this price segment, and if they wanted to consider the Redmi Note 7 Pro. Before I get into the good stuff, I would like to tell you some things that I have noted. Firstly, MIUI ads. They are like everywhere, and after a certain point, it starts to get annoying. I would say that I don't use any of the MI stock apps, but sometimes it pops up in like the middle of the screen, and that's, I don't think that's good, especially when I come from Poco. Poco has no ads. Camera app on the Redmi Note 7 Pro launched with a lot of bugs and issues here and there, but I thought after the updates they will be fixed, and to my surprise it has gotten worse. The stock camera app on opening lags, on closing lags, switching the modes lags, and sometimes when you capture a photo, especially in 48 megapixel mode, it doesn't get saved, and it can be quite a bummer and disappointment if you want to show off the beautiful camera. Mind you, the camera picture quality has not been depreciated. It has, like, I can appreciate the fact that they have kept on improving the overall photo image that is produced, and the 48 megapixel camera also, it's awesome. The poster size photos, if you print them, you can see how beautifully the phone captures it. But the stock camera app, that's a bummer. I would suggest you to use the Gcam port. I would make a video on that too, the best Gcam port. And basically we have the camera to API enabled, so it would be super easy, barely an inconvenience. And the third thing is the haptic vibrations are pretty dull. They have been tuned up a little bit, but it's still less when compared to other phones. So it's kind of a hardware problem. MIUI can't do anything. Yeah, that's one problem that some of you might feel annoying after a certain point. But I can bear with it. It's not something that I would notice very frequently. Okay, that said, let's hit the red subscribe button, get me to 400 subscribers soon, and turn up the gray like thumbs up button into blue. Get me to around 30, 40, 50 likes, and share it to your friends and family. Again, let's get into the good stuff, the pros, and everything that I like about this device. The SOT battery life is awesome, and it has been consistent and unchanged. The charging time that it takes with the in-box charger is around 2 hours and 10 minutes. That has been the same from the first update till the latest update. And with the Poco F1 fast charger, QC 3.0, I think, it gets reduced to around 1 hour 45, 55 minutes. And if you turn off that phone and charge it, I think you can get the charged up, juiced up device with the Poco F1 charger in around 1 hour 30 minutes, and that's a big deal. So I would recommend, if you are some person that forgets to keep the phone at charge, I would suggest you to buy a fast charger for this device. Okay, performance is top notch. When compared to Poco F1, it's not very far behind, and PUBG performance editing is like super awesome. It's super durable. I'm using it with the case that came in the box, and I didn't have to buy a 1000 rupees case like I did with the Poco F1. Screen and camera bump are good too, and they didn't get dinged up like I thought they would. All other things also, like GPS and Bluetooth, are super okie dokie. Now, is it worth buying right now in June or July? The Redmi K20 is almost here in terms of CPU performance. It's just a beast. GPU is also like far better than Redmi Note 7 Pro, somewhat close to the 845, which is in the Poco F1. But I don't know what price it will launch at. My guesses are like 18,000. And at 18,000, this could be a big thing. Because like just a 4,000 jump and you can get a pretty well comparable phone. So I would suggest you to wait for now and don't buy the Redmi Note 7 Pro. And wait for the K20 launch. I'm talking about the K20, not the Pro version. If it launches around 16,000 or 18,000 and you can make the jump from 14,000 to 16 or 18, I think the Redmi K20 will be a much more stellar deal when compared to the Redmi Note 7 Pro. But like if you have just drowned your phone or you have messed up your phone and you want to buy a phone right now, the Redmi Note 7 Pro is the way to go. I don't have any complaints. And it's like super worth for what you pay for. The cameras are pretty dope. The looks and designs are pretty dope. But yeah, the bugs, I have considered them. But still, I would look over them because it's such a value for money device. Okay, don't forget to hit that red glowing subscribe button and subscribe for more tech content. Thumbs up and share it to your friends and family. That's it from my side. That's all that I have for you today. If you liked it, I would suggest you to share it because people might like it too. Okay, this is Tanu Srivastava from Eccentric Tech signing off. Meet you in the next video. Until then, stay safe, stay techie.